Oh, it's Gold Ball Saturday for high school football at Fitzpatrick Stadium, the final game of the night, providing the most drama, the Class B title. Marshwood, the Cinderella story, taking on unbeaten Mount Blue. Down 7-0, Cameron Roll finds Bo Blanchett. The tight end for Marshwood's going to rumble 67 yards. Marshwood takes an 8-7 lead. Roll 3 for 428 yards passing. But Mount Blue responds on the ensuing kickoff. Kalen Lucas, see ya, 85 yards, and the fireworks have begun. 15-8, Mount Blue on top. Later on, Chad Luker, the beginning of a big night. His second of 5 touchdown runs, 20-8, Mount Blue looks like they might pull away. Late in the second, though, Marshwood faced with 4th and 4. Cameron Roll, what else is he going to do? Rolling out to the corner. The score, it's 26-21, Mount Blue at the half. Mount Blue in the second half. It's Jordan Whitney. He's got nowhere to go. Big running day. 18 carries, 113 yards on the ground. Busts a big one. That sets up another Luker TD, 38-35, Mount Blue. But Marshwood always had an answer. Dan Lizotte, the TD run from 3 yards out. Excuse me, that makes it 38-35. Marshwood within 3, but Mount Blue comes back. Whitney, only 7 passing attempts, but this one a big one. On a play install a few weeks ago, takes the big hit. Hits Zach Kendall for the score. Mount Blue up 44-35, but Marshwood comes back again. Brett Gary had 108 yards on the ground. This score makes it a 2-point game, 44-42. Marshwood forces the only punt of the game, has a chance to go 90 yards for the win, but would turn it over on the next play after receiving the punt, and a wild one ends with Mount Blue taking it 44-42. Mount Blue's first goal ball since 1980.
Ever since we got to this game, it's all been pressure. The community's like, go get them, boys, all that. You know how it all goes. Hey, and we came and did it.
And they ran the ball well, and we kept answering. We kept playing hard, and we pushed. I've never worked harder in my life, and I don't think any of these guys have, you know. And it feels great. 12-0, Mount Blue Cougars.
All right. A game, Thornton and Lawrence. Thornton's first A title game since 88, and they played Lawrence in that game. And in that game, Kirk Mathau returned the opening kickoff for Lawrence for a touchdown. It was like deja vu all over again. It's Jake Doolin, 89-yard kickoff return on the opening kick, 7-0 Lawrence. But Thornton responds with a drive. Part of their two-headed monster in the backfield, Nick Kenny, that 6-yard score. It's 7-6 Lawrence. Later in the second, Spencer Carey rolls out, hits his man. Aaron LaFrance goes 30 yards for the score. Lawrence, 11-0 coming in with a 14-6 lead, but Thornton goes to work. Eric Christensen, the play action. Dakota Tarbox is open, breaks the tackle at the 5 and goes in for the score. 14-14, we're tied. Later in the second, Lawrence punting from its own end zone. Quinlan O'Brien blocks it, the safety. Lawrence hit a late field goal in the first half to tip the lead 17-16 into the break, but Thornton takes the lead in the third on the Christensen QB keeper, 22-17 TA. Thornton forces a punt later on the next series, and it goes to the wrong man, Justin Libby. Breaks a tackle, breaks to the sideline. He's in the end zone, 30-17. Thornton with a 2-score lead, but Lawrence gets back in it. They come back. Josh Doolin, another big play from the Bulldogs, 54 yards. It's a touchdown game, 30-23. TA in the fourth. Thornton, big play in this one. They got a long distance here, third and long, and Dylan Morton turns the corner, 48 yards deep into Lawrence territory. From there, Libby goes in for his third score of the game, 37-23. Thornton Academy handing Lawrence its first loss of the year, winning the gold ball.
I've been with that group of guys over there, and we've been training as hard as we can for this one moment. We've been dreaming about this moment since we were little kids.
Football is a big tradition in Saco, and now that we brought it back to Saco, it's a big deal. It's been 24 years.
All right, Class C title game. Foxcroft in the state game for the 6th time in the last 11 years, taking on Winslow. Its first C appearance representing the West. Down 7-0. Winslow drives in the second. Zach Guptill, the short TD run. We're tied at 7. But a key moment in this one. Under 30 seconds left in the half. Winslow just trying to kneel on it, but fumbles the exchange. Lou LaFosse recovers for Foxcroft. And then with under 30 left, Donnie Bovee, the touchdown run. Another Boyer. And it's a 15-7 lead for Foxcroft at the break. In the third, to the air, Hunter Law to Ryan Rebar. That would set up Boyer. Big day for him. 113 yards rushing. They take a 22-7 lead. Winslow comes back, waiting this one. Bobby Chouinard to Owen Dutille. It's 22-20, but Foxcroft would run out the clock in the final minutes and hang on to win the Class C title, 22-20, their fifth championship in Class C, capping a great day of Class A, B, and C championship football in Fitzpatrick Stadium.